So we've already discussed some things that are going to affect bone growth, but let's focus on three. We'll start with minerals, and the main mineral when you're talking about bone growth is calcium. Your mother tells you to drink your milk. There's calcium in the milk that's going to make your bones stronger. And that's true. Calcium really does play a role in terms of the integrity of your bones. But there's other minerals that will play a role, phosphorus to a lesser degree, and even smaller degree, magnesium, manganese, fluoride. These will play a role in terms of the efficiency of the secretion of extracellular matrix, as well as just the overall hardening of bone. But calcium's really the big one. Bone is the main storage area for calcium, so this is not only going to affect the skeletal system, but all other organ systems that need calcium in order to function. So muscle contraction needs calcium. In order for your GI to work efficiently, calcium needs to be regulated. Vitamins are going to play a big role as well. So vitamin C will play a big role in terms of synthesis of collagen. So you need to have the proper amounts of vitamin C in order for collagen to be structurally what you need it to be to allow for that flexibility of bone. And then vitamin D is going to play a big role as well. So in our discussions of the integumentary system, in terms of the epidermis, remember that that vitamin precursor is in the skin, which is going to affect eventually the kidney. So that last byproduct or the active form of vitamin D, calcitriol, is going to be formed by the kidneys. Now that's going to play a role in terms of whether you need to have calcium released or not. So as we know, it's going to be stored in the bone, so that plays a big role there. All right, hormones are really where we're going to spend the most of our time talking about factors that are affecting bone growth. And there's two main hormones that I want to discuss, and then we'll talk a little bit about growth hormones at the end. So calcitonin, this is going to be released by the thyroid gland, and your thyroid gland is going to be located right here in your neck. You can feel your Adam's apple or your thyroid cartilage. Kind of right below it is where your thyroid gland is. This is going to release calcitonin. And this is important in terms of increasing osteoblast activity. So osteoblast or bone secretion, okay? So think about that. Think of the implications in terms of this hormone. If your bones are weakened, if you're having issues in terms of osteoblast activity, you want that calcitonin level to go up. Now, conversely, your parathyroid hormones are going to do the opposite. They're going to increase osteoclast activity, so the bone breaking down. And that seems like a bad thing, but if you need calcium to help in terms of making sure everything's moving smoothly in terms of your GI, then that's a natural process. The issue is if parathyroid hormones are kind of activated in terms of overactivation, that can play a big role. So recall that your parathyroids are going to actually be posterior or on the back of their thyroid glands. Estrogen and testosterone are going to play a role in terms of osteoblast secretion. As we discussed when we were talking about osteoporosis, estrogen production slows in women a little bit more quickly than what's happening with males with older age. So that can play a role in terms of the integrity of the bone. And then lastly, human growth hormone, or HGH, which is going to be secreted by the pituitary gland, is going to play a role in terms of the bone development, so earlier on in life. So if there's an overproduction of human growth hormone, that can play a role in terms of gigantism. So if you have individuals that are larger or taller, as well as in terms of width. And then if there's issues in terms of underproduction of HGH, this can play a role in terms of pituitary dwarfism.